How to teach compound interest to kids. With a penny? Stick around, I'm gonna show you exactly how to do that today. This video comes with a warning. I'm about to teach your child a special trick that if they pull it on you, the parent, you will go bankrupt. I am absolutely serious. But don't worry, I'm actually gonna teach it to you so that you won't get tricked by this. But your child will learn something very valuable about compound interest and how it works. So the problem is teaching our kids about money can often be considered a very boring kind of topic. And so we need to make it really fun and exciting and engaging. And so you might be asking, well, how does compound interest for kids, how is that fun? Well, think of it this way. Albert Einstein is often quoted as saying that compound interest is the eighth wonder of the world. And there is a really good reason why. You see, in our last video, we talked about leverage, leveraging ourselves, leveraging our time, and compound interest is like the most amazing version of leveraging your time and your money. And so what I want to share with you today is a special story that you can share with your child to teach them a special trick of how their one penny, that one little penny, could become millions of dollars and literally bankrupt you if you let them play this trick on you. All right, let's get started. Hi, I'm Amanda Vandergulik from CleverDoughKids.com, where I teach financial literacy for kids. And I also teach entrepreneurship and abundance mindset skills. So welcome to my video today. If this is your first time here, I am so grateful to you for teaching your kids about money seriously. So today we're talking about compound interest. Now, if you're not sure what compound interest is, let me give you a really quick understanding and then I'm going to share a story with you. So compounding interest is where you're taking your money and you're earning interest on it, but the interest that you're earning on it you leave together with your original money, and then you earn interest on both of them. You earn interest on your money, and you earn interest on the interest. And then that interest goes back in again. And now you're earning money, on your interest, on your interest's interest, and your interest's interest. Are you following me? So here's my little interest sign. And very happy faces. We love to have our money work hard for us because the thing is, if you can get your money working really hard for you, if you can get your child's money working really hard for them, then you don't have to work really hard for money for the rest of your life, like the majority of people do. All right, so here is a story I want you to share with your children. So there was this girl, Penny. Yeah, I know, I came up with that. And she actually had this really fun idea. She wanted to make some money because she had a goal. She wanted to get herself this big, beautiful red bicycle. And she wanted to earn some money to get to that. And so she was trying to come up with ways. And her parents had said flat out, no, they're not giving an allowance. And she's like, oh my goodness, what else? And she lived way out in the country. So she couldn't, you know, just quickly go easily work for somebody else. So she had to be really inventive, really creative. And her mom had already told her she was not getting any money for normal household chores because she was part of the family. And that was just being part of the family. So she's like, oh my goodness, what can I do? What can I do? But then one day she was watching her mom weeding the garden. And she noticed that her mom was suffering, like every time she'd bend down to weed plants, her one knee would give out and she felt really awful. So she thought, well, I'll help my mom. So she helped her mom with some weeding and she said, well, why don't you just go and rest, mom? And I can weed for a little bit for you because I don't want you hurting. And so her mom gratefully sat on the side and said, oh, thank you, honey. But she felt kind of bad that her little girl was now weeding this huge garden. And her daughter, Penny, she was like, no, it's okay, mom. I'll help you. And then Penny got this idea and she said, mom, I know I'm helping you right now today with the weeding because your knee is hurting. But what if, because I know weeding the garden is not one of the regular chores that you have me do, right, mom? And her mom was like, no, that's right, sweetheart. It's my job. I do it. But mom, your knee is hurting today and it probably will keep on hurting every day. Like, you got to take care of your knee. If you keep weeding, it's going to keep hurting. And her mom could see that Penny was right, but she really didn't want her daughter to be doing the weeding because she was a little girl and it was a lot of work. And Penny was like, no, it's fine, Mom. I can do this and I have an idea. And okay, what's your idea, sweetheart? Well, Mom, what if you just paid me a penny today to do the gardening? A penny is not very much, sweetheart. I don't think you understand the value of money. I think you're underestimating your own value. And Penny said, no, it's okay, Mom, because I really want to help you and I just want to start earning some money. So I'll do it today for a penny. All right, but it doesn't feel right. No, it's okay, Mom, because what if then tomorrow you pay me 2 pennies? And her mom's like, this is a pretty sweet deal. All right. And then Penny said, yeah. What if every day when I do the weeding, you just pay me a penny today, and then you just pay me 2 pennies tomorrow, and then just like double it. So like 4 pennies the next day. And so her mom's like, okay, this is gonna be like the cheapest weeding I've ever had. But you know what? It's a good experience for my daughter to really understand her true value, her true worth, because she won't be able to buy much for a couple of pennies. And so she's like, I think I'm going to do this in her head. Of course, she's not telling Penny this. I think I'm going to do this just so that she can learn that she is worth more than just a couple of pennies, because it's a lot of weeding. So day one, Penny does some weeding on one part of the garden and her mom pays her a penny. The next day she goes out and she weeds a little bit more in the garden and her mom pays her 2 pennies. By the end of the week, after every day, the penny doubling every single day, Penny was so excited. She had earned 64 pennies. For the week. She was thrilled and her mom was like, this experience is not working. She's not understanding that she's worth a lot more than 64 cents for all the work she's been doing. But her knee was hurting and she needed the help and her daughter was insisting, no, Mom, it's okay. So she just kept going. So the next week, out Penny would go. She'd weed the gardens again. She'd come back and her mom would then double the amount and pay her for that day. Well, by the end of the second week, she realized that she actually owed Penny $81.92. How did that happen? But at least she kind of felt a little bit better because she did not feel good about paying her daughter a couple of pennies for weeding the garden. So she felt at least, you know, $81 for the 2 weeks of this extra work, that was at least a little bit better. You know, her daughter is starting to feel a little more value, so at least she was hoping she was. So she just paid her up and then she let her continue for the next week because it was a huge garden and it needed a lot of work and her knee was still bothering her. So she went out, or her daughter Penny went out, and she kept on weeding, and at the end of the day she'd come back in and check in with her mom. Well, by the end of the third week, Mom was in a little bit of a panic. Okay, so more like a huge panic, because she owed her over $10,000. How did this happen? $10,485.76, to be exact. As you can imagine, Mom and Penny had to renegotiate because Mom was going bankrupt. Seriously, bankrupt. So they renegotiated, but can you imagine if she had still had to pay after the fourth week? After 28 days of weeding the garden, she would have owed over $1 million. $1 million. Do you understand like the concept of compounding interest now? After 28 days. After 30 days, she would have owed her over $5.3 million. And maybe it was a month with 31 days. That's over $10 million that she would have owed her daughter just because she started with one penny doubled every single day. So that's just a really fun story that you can tell your child, and obviously do not fall for this trick of how by having it double, having double, you can create more and more wealth for yourself with less and less effort. Now, it's not an exact example, because of course we didn't take the one penny and then earn like 10% and then have a penny in a tenth and then earn 10% on that and so on. But I wanted to use simple numbers to help your child just understand the concept of having it double by keeping the money in double, because that's what happens, even though it might be like a tenth instead of 50% or 100% or 200%. But you know what I mean? So I wanted to make sure that your child could understand this in a really fun way. And hey, they can try and see if they can play this trick on somebody. just not on you. And we have more stories just like that one in the Cleverdough Kids Academy. I'll leave a link to it below for you so you can go check that out. Because again, storytelling is the best way for your child to learn solid financial literacy skills to make sure that they are money masters for life. So again, when you're looking for an education program for financial literacy for kids, you really want to make sure that first of all, whoever your child is learning from is a parent and understands the needs of your child and has a vested interest in wanting your child to succeed because they see your child as one of their own children. The second thing is that they do use the power of storytelling and immersing your child emotionally in the lessons so that they feel that they are part of them and therefore the lessons will stick for life. And of course, the third one being that they must be personally vested and really excited to want to learn about money because the program itself makes them so personally attached to the goals that they set for themselves that they are proud and excited to not only do the course themselves but to share it with all of their friends and family. So again, I invite you to take a look at the Cleverdough Kids Academy below. I am so excited to have it available for you. Would you do me a huge favor and quickly, if you found today's video helpful, will you give me a thumbs up? It helps the algorithm share this video with more families, and I'm on a mission, and I hope you'll join me on my mission to raise 1,000 families with money smart kids. Now leave a comment below and tell me what has been your most challenging situation when it comes to teaching your kids about money. You know, do you have any questions of like other ways of how to teach compounding interest to children and kids? Or do you have anything in particular? Maybe you have questions about allowances or how your child can make money and so on. Leave me a comment below. I read them all. I answer them and I look forward to continuing this conversation. Now in the next video, this is the video that you have to see if you seriously want to do less work and earn more money and you want to make sure that your child, once they leave your protective financial nest, never ever has to come crawling back home to you to take care of them financially, which will kill their self-esteem, which causes all kinds of financial stress and physical problems related to financial stress and emotional problems related to it with their future relationships. This is key, but this is also the thing that will give you financial freedom. So I'm really excited to share it with you, and it's passive income. And I'll see you in this video next, and I'll share all of that there.